Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to paint this a bit more complicated cloud painting here. So, we're gonna start with the underpainting. Basically, just two different colors. One for the back, a bit darker one. And one for the front. And yeah, put it on pretty sloppy. The smaller brush here. And then level it out again to have this more, this even surface. The blender brush. This is the reference material that we're gonna use. And these are the brushes that we will use for this painting. Now we start again with the back. We mixed some more colors here, as you can see. And I already start to establish the shape of the clouds by adding more of the darker color to the front. This here is now the way I build up this fuzzy background cloud here. Basically putting on the colors really sloppy, as you can see. Then I grab this very soft blender brush and rub it into the still wet color here. It's really nice transition between the colors. So I build up this whole background here. Extremely sloppy, putting on the colors roughly, and then just blending. And this saves really a lot of time doing it that way. And you also get some really nice fluffy looking, very soft clouds for the background. This video here will also be available as a real-time, full-time tutorial with comments on my Patreon and on my website. So, we start now with the cloud in the foreground. An important thing is here that the background, the dark bluish color here, is still wet. So we can still basically connect the two layers together. This cloud in the front and the layer on the back, as you can see. You don't want to do it in other places, but you need to have some spots in the clouds where this happens, where the background melts into the cloud and the other way around. Here again, I put in the colors, first pretty rough. Then I grab a soft blender brush with no color on and soften it down. Clouds usually have the tendency to not have too many sharp edges. You want to have some edges in, but most of the time you need to put in very soft transitions. This is now the part where I build up the main center point of this painting here, the main cloud. I use a very soft and very small brush here to get in those tiny little details on the edges of this cloud here. And it's also important that this background is still wet so that we can blend the cloud the foreground into the back. So we have these very tiny things extending from the cloud. I see here the palette that I'm using. And I basically build up the whole thing by mixing colors as I go, more or less. According to the reference material that I have. And this here is a very important aspect here. Clouds are not cut out. Clouds have the roundness and the shape, basically, of a bowl. And you definitely need to put that in to get this roundness of the clouds onto the canvas. I follow the reference material. I mean, not completely like a slave, but pretty close anyway. And yeah, adding all those different colors to get not only the cloud in, but also the light effects that we have, the reflections from the clouds on the left side that reflect on the left part of the cloud on the right side here. So this whole thing basically needs also reflections from the strong sunlight that hits the whole thing here to look really realistic. Therefore, I add more and more details and more color, adjusting the tones, brightness, darkness of the whole thing to get this thing realistic looking onto the canvas. And you also see that the palette, how can I put it, more or less starts to become one layer of color that is evenly mixed. I start out with a very nice orderly palette, but I most of the time end up with the palette looking like this here. Because I always need those in-between tones that you can't remix. Here I'm adding now some more details, a very fine brush. I think detail is another key here when it comes to painting this thing realistic. I mean, it's a tiny painting, but it's still requires a lot of detail for this whole thing to look realistic. So I get them in and then I start to blend the whole thing, soften the edges down. And then I go back again, mix some even darker color, and start to build up some more layers of the cloud. I do this by adding some darker tones here. As you can see, adding some more cloud shapes to this whole thing. And then I blend those darker colors into the still wet color. With this simple trick, you build up another layer of a cloud, and this adds more depth to this whole cloud painting here. And again, after that, you need to blend again. Another big advantage of these water mixable oils that I use is that you can adjust the color by mixing fresh color into the still wet color that we have. Yeah, so I basically build up the whole thing. It's now the left part. A bit brighter, as you can see. Put in the first lighter colors. Pretty edgy, pretty rough, just to get them established where they are. And then I add the darker colors here and start to blend with the smaller brush. As I said before, you need those edgy parts, but also you also need to have these places where the clouds melt into one another. And that's what I basically do here now. I'm adding one of the darkest spots here. Part of the cloud that is the shadows from the cloud on the right side here, as you can see. And I constantly adjust this whole thing, adding more darker colors when I think I need them. I mean, of course, I premix the colors and try to stick close to the reference material that I have, but I can't stick to it like a slave. You need to adjust this whole thing while you keep on painting. I see, it's a pretty easy thing to build up details like this very washy, cloudy thing here on the bottom of the painting here. You just need to brush on the colors and then you need to blend with a very soft and bigger brush. And then you achieve a pretty nice effect of this cloud part here melting into the background. Same goes here. Having some edgy parts and some parts that really melt into the background. Adding some more final details and we're basically finished. After some more blending, of course. I bet you wanna see more cloud painting tutorials here. Got here a whole list of them. Check them out.